Well, I've gone through the grade 7 class. I've got two primary school, the NS class. Today we're going to talk about transferring of heat. Okay, so you can follow me there on page 110 up to page 119 as we talk about the transferring of heat. Heat is an energy that can be transformed from one place to another. So it is important for us to remember that energy flows and it actually is transferred from one place to another. During the process of heating energy, it can be transformed from a warmer place to a cooler place. Heat is transferred in from a warmer to a cooler object and continues to flow until both of the sides are the same temperature. So if you put a piece of iron inside of the fire, the heat will keep on transferring until both sides are the same temperature. Okay, so firstly, the way heat is transferred, there's three ways and heat is transferred. Number one, conduction. Conduction takes place in solid objects. Convection takes place in liquids and gases, and radiation takes place in an empty space. Okay, so let us go look deeper into this kind of okay. The first one is conduction. Conduction takes place in solid objects. So we have learned that solid objects consist out of particles that are packed very close to one another. So they have a fixed position and the particles vibrate against one another. So what actually happens is, as the particles are very close to one another, and as the heat heat is absorbed by the particles, heat is transferred from one particle to another, and that we call conduction. So this takes place in mainly metals, that is a solid. Remember now, metals are very good conductors of electricity and also of heat. So remember now, the purer the metal, the better a conductor it will be. So if we talk about pure metals, we talk about pure copper, pure gold, pure silver, and so forth. And then we also get alloys. Alloy metal is a combination of different materials that makes actually up a metal. We call it alloy metals. For example, stainless steel is a combination of iron, of carbon, and also chrome that are put together. So that is why we make pots from metal, but the handles we make from, it's something that is not a metal, like for example plastic or wood, that so that the heat, because they plastic and wood is very good insulators, and so they insulate the heat from the pot and from my hands, so that my hands do not burn when I pick up the hot pot. Okay, so that is how we use it practically in our everyday life. Here is an example of very good conductors, very good insulators, as we have seen in the experiment that we have done. Okay, comparing different kinds of metals and the conduction of heat to a different area and so forth. Okay, the second one is convection. Convection takes place in air and also in liquids. So remember now that cool air is very heavy. The moment it comes into the window, the cool air goes to the bottom of the glass, and hot air is very light, and it goes to the top of the glass. And the moment it goes to the top of the glass, it makes space for the cool air to actually flow into the glass. What actually happens is, in figure 4, there you have a candle. Where the candle is burning, it's heating up the air particles above the candle. So the moment hot air rises to the top, it makes space for the cooler air to take its place. So constantly next to a candle there will be that convection taking place. Also, it happens inside of a kettle. That's why the element of a kettle is at the bottom of the kettle, so that it heats the particles that is at the bottom. The moment the particles are heated up, they rise inside and it makes space for the other particles, and we actually have a convection stream inside of a kettle or in a glass or around the kettle, around the candle, as we have talked about that. So make sure that you understand how convection is taking place in our everyday life. If you want, for example, that's why the freezer, in a single door freezer, you will see that the cooling system is at the top of the freezer so that the cool air will flow to the bottom. If you want a heater to actually work at its best, you put the heater at the very low part of the room so that the cool air that's on the ground is heated up immediately. The hot air rises to the top, the cool air is heated up, and so forth. You actually create a convection stream inside of the glass. The same with an air conditioner. You put it at the top of a glass to make it work more effective. So the air conditioner takes up the hot air from the roof, and it actually cools it down, and the cool air falls to the ground from the top of the air conditioner. So that is how we actually let systems the transferring of heat and so forth in our everyday life, how the systems actually works for us to make things actually better. Okay, the last way of heat how heat is transferred is by radiation. Radiation is by, if I talk about radiation, I talk about the sun. So radiation is where the sun's rays is actually coming to the earth. Remember, the sun is like 150 million kilometers from the earth. So from the sun to us, there's an open space. So if it was convection that heated up the earth by the sun, the gas would go up. And that is not actually how it takes place. If I can give an example of everyday life, if we look at a fire, when you have your hands on top of the fire, you can feel the fire burning. When you put a piece of iron inside of the fire, that is conduction. When I have my hands above the fire, that is convection. But if I stand next to the fire and I feel the heat, that is the radiation. So that is actually what's happening. So if the radiation of the sun comes to an object, it does three things. Number one, it is transmitted, like for example through a window. Through a window it is transmitted, by a mirror it is reflected, and by a very dark surface it is absorbed. If I think about a tar road, that is very dark of color, so it absorbs the sun's rays. So so that is how what actually happens when the sun's rays is coming to an object. Three things happen: it is transmitted, it went through the glass, or it is reflected by a mirror, or it is absorbed by a tar road. So I hope you have learned something about the ways heat is transferred from one object to another in the three different ways. Number one, conduction in solids, convection in liquids and gases, and radiation in empty spaces.